हेलो स्टूडेंट, वेलकम टू वास्टेक चैनल। दिस वसंत नायक फ्रॉम कैनरा इंजीनियरिंग कॉलेज। टुडे इन दिस सेशन वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी ARM एम्बेडेड सिस्टम मॉड्यूल 4 ऑफ माइक्रोप्रोसेसर एंड माइक्रोकंट्रोलर 17CS44 syllabus of VTU for CS and IS students of 4th semester. So ARM, the full name for ARM is Advanced RISC Machine. It is a microcontroller. It is a processor. ARM processor core is a key component in many embedded system. AR cores are widely used by mobile phones, handheld organizations, multitude of other everyday portable consumer device, etc. The first ARM core was found in 1985. The success for ARM is because of a simple and powerful original design which continues to improve today through constant technical innovations. So in our discussion, we use ARM7 TDMI processor. So now, what are the advantages of this one? We'll see. ARM core uses reduced instruction set RISC. So now, what is the design philosophy of RISC? Design philosophy of RISC is delivering simple but powerful instruction. Reduced instruction set means most of the people will think the instructions are reduced. It is not instructions are reduced. It is multiple form of instructions are reduced. For example, in CISC, you have add instruction for register, add instruction if you use memory. But in RISC, all the additions will take place. I mean, all the instructions will be executed in register only. That's why which has got reduced instruction set compared to CISC processor. RISC will place greater demands on the compiler. So here you can see the difference between CISC and RISC. So here greater complexity on compiler in case of RISC. In case of CISC, greater complexity on the processor. That means CISC will based on the hardware design, like it will put complexity on hardware design, but here RISC will put complexity on compiler design, that is on the software fault. So that is the difference. Other than that, the difference between CISC and RISC, once again you will see, CISC is a complex instruction set computing and RISC is a simple instruction. What is the meaning of that one? Complex instruction which was used by 8086 and other processor, Intel processor, which will take multiple clock because which has got variable instruction format. One cycle execution, two cycle execution, three cycle execution, four cycle execution, like that. Variable format of instructions are there. But RISC is a simple fixed format of instruction. All these instructions will execute in single clock cycle. And here, emphasis on hardware. CISC will put the emphasis on hardware. RISC will put the emphasis on software. Complex instructions. Here it is reduced instruction. As I said, the complex instruction means, for example, if you take add instruction, add AX, BX, one form of instruction, add AX, the bracket 2000, that is nothing but a direct mode, that is in all memory operation, that is one more instruction. Such type of instructions are reduced in RISC, that's why it is called reduced instruction. Fourth one is variable format. Here it is a fixed format. That's why RISC is powerful. Fixed format instruction which will take exactly one cycle to execute. So it is a powerful. And CISC, fifth point, many instructions and many addressing mode. Here RISC, fixed instruction and few addressing mode. Conditional jumps, here also conditional jumps. Then memory reference is embedded in many instruction. Memory reference is here is only RISC instruction makes use of memory reference only for load and store, just to load the instruction from the memory and to store the result to the memory. Rest of the time, all the execution take place in register. That is the difference between CISC and RISC. So here we will see once again RISC design rules: reduced number of instructions, simple operation. Each instruction can execute in one clock cycle. Compiler complicated operation. Each instruction is having fixed length that allows pipeline to fetch future instructions. So if the instructions are fixed length, then pipeline will work properly. If the instruction is a variable length, pipeline will not work properly. That is the main intention here we want to tell you. In 8086 or Intel says they are using pipeline, but they are using different format, variable format of instruction. When the variable format of instructions are there, each instruction may take different time to execute. Then how exactly the pipeline works? Because in pipeline, one instruction depends on the other instruction. So how it will work? So exactly telling in Intel family, x86 pipelining is will not work to the full extent compared to ARM or RISC design. So we can say 3-stage pipeline of RISC is equal to 6-stage pipeline of x86 family. So what are the other advantages? So first one is instruction, second one is pipeline, third one is a register. This contains large number of register. For example, our TDM7, ARM7 processor contains 37 registers. Out of that, at any time 16 registers are visible. So that is the difference. Most of the time, 95% of the time, all the instructions are executed in register only, and register are internal to the processor. That's why it is faster compared to memory. So registers are faster. So what is the design philosophy of ARM processor? The design philosophy of ARM, since ARM is used in embedded system, it requires most of the embedded system requirement is battery power. The power consumption should be low. So ARM processor specially designed to be small. When the processor is small, it will naturally reduce the consumption of power, and it will extend the battery operation. Second one is high code density. Embedded systems have limited memory due to cost and physical size restriction. So this is useful application that have limited on the onboard memory, such as mobile phones and mass storage device. Third one is embedded systems are price sensitive. Because of price sensitive, how it will help in ARM? ARM has reduced the area of the die taken up by the embedded processor. So ARM die size is very small, which will reduce the cost. So it will help in terms of price sensitive. And ARM also incorporated hardware debug technology. instruction set of embedded. Instruction set of embedded is a some instructions are variable cycle execution. Most of these instructions are single cycle execution. Then it has got inline barrel shifter. Normally, shifter always arithmetic and logic unit has got shifter, but this one is help in improving the performance. And instruction set of embedded systems are support 16-bit also. That is called thumb instruction set, and it also supports conditional execution and enhanced instructions. So now variable cycle is execution for certain instructions. So certain instruction like load and store, multiple instructions are variable cycle execution. Not all the instructions, like 95% of the instructions are executed in single cycle, and some instructions are variable cycle for variable cycle execution. That is one, that is the one point you have to remember. Second one is ARM has got inline barrel shifter. So what is the main use of the inline barrel shifter? So barrel shifter is a digital circuit that can shift the world by specified number of bits without use of any sequential logic, which makes use of only pure combination logic. Pure combination logic means just like by using basic gates, not by using like flip-flops and other type of sequential logics. So what is the use of this barrel shifter? Barrel shifter will improve the core performance by executing the instruction in advance before executing the in ALU. And thumb is a 16-bit instruction. ARM also supports 16-bit instruction. This is called as miniature version of the instruction set. So this will improve the performance. And it also supports conditional executions and enhanced execution, which will also improve the performance of the ARM. So now the architecture of embedded system hardware. The embedded system hardware architecture, you can see here what embedded system contains. Embedded system contains ARM processor, other than that interrupt controller, then this one bus controller and bus, AHB external bus, external bridge, memory controller, other than that real-time clock, serial UARTs for serial communication, Ethernet for Ethernet connection, LAN connection, and counter and timers. All these are the different functional units of embedded system. So this is the architecture of embedded system. This is not the architecture of ARM. So in that embedded system, ARM processor is the one component. So the four main hardwares of ARMs are hardware components are ARM processor, controllers, peripherals, bus. ARM processor compromise core with the surrounding components like memory and cache, controls the embedded device. Different version of ARM processors are available. So controllers coordinate important functional blocks of the system. Two commonly used controllers are interrupt and memory controllers. Peripherals provides all input-output. Peripheral provides input-output capability external to chip. Bus is used to communicate between different parts of the device. So ARM bus technology. So ARM bus technology, you can see ARM bus technology. Normally ARM bus technology is called as AMBA.